I never thought I'd ever be making this video. What is considered the holy grail of bases has finally been found on the oldest Anarchy server in Minecraft. For years, it was a place of urban legend that some even doubted was real. A base that, according to all public records, was completely destroyed 6 years ago in one of the most famous griefs in the server's history. But unknown to almost all, the base was not actually destroyed. When a 2v2t legend gained backdoor access to the server, he created an exact replica of the entire base. Using WorldEdit, he moved it millions of blocks away from spawn so that no one would find it. This event would begin one griefer's quest for revenge that would last almost 6 years and has led us to this very moment. The mathematical method used to find the base is nothing short of incredible and was only possible thanks to three players coming together and working off of a single blurry image that most would have considered useless. Today, I'll be telling you the story of how 2v2t's most highly sought after base, Imps 2, was finally found. A history of betrayals, hacking, sabotage, and revenge. This all started 9 years ago. In 2012, a base was founded called Imperator's Base, or Imps Base for short. While it was originally called Viking Base, it was renamed after one of the active members, Imperator Terra. Over the years, it would become one of the largest bases by area on the server, as well as the most secretive. While it had many fantastic builds, the focal point of the base was a replica of Christ the Redeemer, the famous statue from Brazil. The build would become so iconic that it was featured on the original 2v2t website. Needless to say, players began to wonder where this build was actually located. So even in the early years, this base had some mystique behind it. One of the members was a powerful player named iTristan, who was well known in the community as a hacker and programmer. In early 2015, while chatting in a 2v2t Skype group, he accidentally posted a picture of the base, but quickly removed it after noticing. He hoped that no one else had saved it, but it turns out someone did. One of Tristan's friends, Jared2013, had saved the image just before deletion. He was known as a griefer on the server, but wasn't planning on destroying imps. He simply kept the image for his own amusement. But as 2015 went on, there was a falling out between the two. No one knows exactly what caused their friendship to fall apart, but it was significant enough for Jared to take action. He decided he was going to destroy imps in order to cement his legacy as a griefer. But little did he know that while he was planning the grief, the members of Imps had caught wind of his plan and were already one step ahead. You see, the reason Tristan had a reputation as a powerful player was because he was friendly with the server's admin, Housemaster. In the past, he had created server plugins for him and secretly coded them to give himself backdoor advantages, such as being able to walk on the nether roof or spawning in illegal items. But eventually, House stopped trusting Tristan, and he had to become more clever if he wanted more advantages. The members of Imps came up with a plan. They convinced House that the server needed a new website, and even offered to pay a developer to build it. When it was finished, Tristan secretly added malicious code before they sent it back to House. The website was now running on the same box as 2v2t itself, meaning the code gave them backdoor access. I use the term backdoor, but realistically, what Tristan now had was root access, making him just as powerful as Housemaster. He could use any admin command and use things such as WorldEdit to change the physical landscape of the server. He would actually test out some of these powers near spawn. He duplicated an entire region of chunks, making two identical areas right next to each other. After realizing areas of the server could be cloned, Imperator requested that Tristan make an exact replica of their base and place it millions of blocks away from spawn so that no one could find it. This replica could be used as a backup in case the real Imps was griefed by Jared. Tristan managed to pull it off and create a nearly identical copy of Imps Base. After a few days, House discovered the exploit and took down the website. This removed their route access, but the plan had already succeeded. Now that they had the replica, they were ready for whatever Jared was planning. On Christmas Eve 2015, Jared showed up at Imp Space and began griefing it. The base was so massive that it took him over 48 hours just to destroy it. Shulker boxes didn't exist yet, so much of the TNT had to be transported the old-fashioned way. When the grief was done, the base members taunted Jared, claiming that he had only destroyed the backup. He walked away from the ruins, vowing that if Imps 2 actually existed, that he would one day find it and destroy it, no matter how long it took. As time went on, the ungriefed base sat in silence with no visitors. Jared continued searching for any information he could find. The old members, one by one, slowly made their way out to the replica. Because Tristan only had a few days to copy the base in 2015, it had some irregularities. Some of the chests had no items in them, so gear had to be brought in manually. The base also contained massive chunk borders on the edges, since they clashed with the natural terrain. Most members opted to simply have an account there for nostalgia purposes, and had no interest in actually building anything new. So from 2016 to 2018, there was radio silence. But of course, when you're sitting on the biggest secret in the server's history, it's only natural that someone is going to brag about it. 2018 is when information about the base began to leak. This is around the time I first heard the rumor of a copy of Imps actually existing, but like everyone else, I had no way of proving it was real. The first batch of info to leak were screenshots of the base that had been shared privately by one of the members, Oftopia. Visually, there was not enough to determine the location the screenshots were taken in, so most people thought they were fake. The second batch of information, ironically, came from Tristan, the same person to leak the original Imps base to Jared. He had been doing a stream of the base on Discord, and for a split second, showed a folder on his computer that contained what appeared to be region files, which are used to store chunk information in Minecraft. But since Tristan had moved the window as the screenshot was taken, it was so blurry that it was considered useless. Regardless, when Jared got his hands on this information, he began looking for people that could help him. It turns out, he wasn't the only one that wanted revenge. By 2021, Tristan and his group, Nerds Incorporated, had spent years griefing bases all over the server and in the process made a lot of enemies and rubbed people the wrong way. Two of these people were named Orsund and Hermetic Lock. Like Jared, they too had been looking for the rumored Imps copy, but for different reasons. Orsund was looking for it because he viewed the base as a symbol of the server's darkest period, when a select group of players had control over everyone else. It was an affront to anarchy. Hermetic Lock was a well-known member of 2B2T's community and had done almost everything there is to do on the server. He wanted to search for the base because he viewed it as one of the last unique experiences he could have. So the three players joined forces and combined their resources. Being a talented programmer, Orson decided to look at the blurry region files. Remember, this image had been considered useless by almost everyone else that had seen it. Which is why it was so surprising then, when he told the others that he had found a way to actually read it. First, he identified the program Tristan had been using as WinRAR. Then, he determined that the Windows font being used was Sago. All region files in Minecraft end with the file extension MCA. So by downscaling text using Sago font with the correct space between the characters, he was able to determine the geometric length of the region files on the screenshot. Each one was 3 digits, which meant that the region files had to be somewhere between 100 and 999 on each axis. Now, to turn region files into actual Minecraft coordinates, you simply multiply them by 512. The deciphered region files turned out to be in the Nether, which meant they also had to be multiplied by 8, which means that the farthest out the base could possibly be was 4,091,000 blocks. He had a possible range, but he needed a direction. Orson took Oftopia's leaked screenshots and was able to determine based on the text that was visible that the base had been moved from the northwest quadrant to the northeast. on a hunch, his best guess was that Tristan was trying to do three things. Keep the base far out of range of most players in 2015, keep it off an axis as the original had been built almost directly on one, and send the base to a different quadrant. This meant the x-coordinate must have been multiplied by -3, and the z-coordinate was multiplied by 1.5, with some of the numbers changed randomly. Remember, a Minecraft world can be 60 million by 60 million blocks, so the fact that they were able to narrow it down to under 4 million in a single direction meant that searching for the base was now plausible. The three split up and began their search. At this point, it was only a matter of time. Mathematically, they gave themselves potential coordinates to check out, and during their search, they came across some bizarre findings. Player dug tunnels that were somehow in freshly generated chunks, multiple nether portals in the overworld which were unlit, chunk trails that seemed to just move in straight lines with no other signs of player tampering. It was eerie. As the months went by, the three started going insane, searching endless nether chunks with only the occasional lead. Just as they had started giving up hope, in May of 2021, the unthinkable happened. Orsund had found it. He had found Imps 2 in all of its glory. The base that had become an urban legend was real, and he was seeing it with his own eyes. It was almost identical to the old world downloads. Surprisingly, the base didn't seem active, so his fear of being spotted quickly went away. He saw illegally placed spawners all over the base, rare items in storage that collectors would love to get their hands on, a massive hole going all the way down to bedrock that had been world edited near the base. There were even builds on the outskirts that weren't at the original. He noticed there were signs around indicating that other players had slowly been invited over the years. It was the holy grail of 2B2T bases. He quickly sent coordinates to Jared and Herm, and with both of them on the way, began planning the Big Bang. Even with three of them, they knew how long it was going to take, so they set up a base of operations and agreed on a time. On May 29th, 2021, the three laid the first batch of TNT at Imps. They would spend the next 15 hours destroying as much of the base as they could. As the hours passed, they began inviting people to their Discord to watch the spectacle unfold. Many of the server's old players that had quit years ago came back to watch the destruction. On one hand, people were celebrating that Tristan, who had griefed countless bases over the years, was finally getting a taste of his own medicine, while also acknowledging that the destruction of this base was the end of an era. The last true remnant of the old 2B2T was finally crumbling. It was bittersweet. After almost 6 years, Jared had finally gotten his revenge. Orsund had proven himself as one of the greatest base hunters on the entire server, and Hermetic Lock finally had a truly unique experience to add to his list of accomplishments. News of the base's final destruction spread quickly, and much speculation occurred. If a copy of Imps existed on 2B2T all these years, what other mysteries could be out there? After this long journey, you hitting that subscribe button would mean a lot to me. Also, don't forget to like the video and follow my socials. But that's it for now, FitFam, so take it easy and stay alive out there.